So let's get started. What you'll need: an Intel-based Mac system, downloaded copy of macOS Sierra installer, and finally, a fast USB 3.0 flash or external SSD drive. As usual, since we'll be using disk utility, make sure that you have or made a backup of your system hard drive or drives before proceeding. Can't say you've not been warned. Now, with all the basic necessities taken care of, the first thing we need to do after installing the SSD drive in an available USB 3.0 socket is to open disk utility and partition the SSD drive. Therefore, after opening disk utility, click on the SSD drive in the sidebar, then click the partition button shown here. Now name your partition to whatever you like and make sure that the format is OS X Extended Journal. Then click the apply button to format and partition the SSD drive. After formatting and partitioning the SSD drive, you can close disk utility and simply launch the macOS Sierra installer and choose to install Sierra on the SSD drive just formatted and partitioned as shown here. I'll just time-lapse the installation process from here, which took about 14 minutes to complete to the point where you begin to select your location. Once the required login details have been entered, you're brought to the Sierra desktop. At this point, it's advisable to change the startup disk order from the SSD drive to your default startup drive of your Mac, which in my case is the Macintosh HD as shown here. Once that's taken care of, I'll just shut down the Mac and proceed with the power and option key combination to boot to the startup manager and click the SSD drive to launch macOS Sierra as shown.